In this video, I will go over how to write molecular equations, total ionic equations, and net ionic equations. We have previously gone over writing of chemical reactions. The types of chemical reactions we have gone over are combination or synthesis reactions, decomposition reactions, single displacement reactions, combustion reactions, and double displacement reactions. Remember that there are three types of double displacement reactions: precipitation, gas, and acid-base reactions. If you are not comfortable with writing these types of reactions, please review your notes and quickly get help before you need to know the materials for this video, because it will not make any sense at all. Before I go on, I need to explain the difference between the five types of chemical reactions that we have gone over in class and that I've mentioned at the start of this video, and the three types of equation that this video is trying to explain. In general, a chemical reaction occurs when one or more reactant molecules rearrange themselves to form new product molecules. For each chemical reaction written, you can write three equations based on that particular chemical reaction. When you are given reactants, the first equation that you need to be able to write is a molecular equation. The molecular equation is a balanced chemical equation where the compounds are expressed as molecules instead of component ions. The next equation, based on the same chemical reaction, is the total ionic equation. The total ionic equation is an equation based on the molecular equation that breaks up all the molecules in the aqueous phase into its component ions. The last equation is the net ionic equation. In this equation, only the important ions and species are written down. Understanding the four states of matter, solid, liquid, gas, and aqueous, is very important in writing these equations. Let's write the double displacement precipitation reaction between lithium phosphate and calcium chloride. You can pause the video to write the balanced equation. Don't forget to include the states. Your molecular equation for this reaction should look like this. 2 moles of lithium phosphate in the aqueous state reacts with 3 moles of calcium chloride in the aqueous state to form 6 moles of lithium chloride in the aqueous state and 1 mole of calcium phosphate in the solid state. This is considered as the molecular equation because all the reactants and products are written as neutral compounds. The next equation you will write is a total ionic equation that is based on the molecular equation that was just written. In this type of equation, all the molecules in the aqueous phase are broken down to its ionic components, take into account of the subscripts and the coefficients. But if the state is a solid, liquid, or gas, the molecule or atom is left alone and copied and written as is. It is really important to understand the different states of matter, solid, liquid, gas, and aqueous, and how to determine each one. I have given hints and clues in class on how to determine the different states of matter. Please review it so that you have the information to write the equations correctly. As previously stated, you will need to take into account the subscript and coefficient. This is an important concept to understand, coefficients versus subscript. The subscript is a number you use to balance the atoms and charges when writing the molecular compound. In the videos on naming compounds, you use subscripts to balance the charges. The coefficients, on the other hand, are the numbers you add to the front of the molecules or the compounds to balance the equation. So back to the equation. Lithium phosphate, calcium chloride, and lithium chloride are all aqueous solutions, whereas calcium phosphate is a solid. So when you write the total ionic equation, the aqueous states will be broken up into its component ions, take into account of the coefficient and subscript, while calcium phosphate, a solid, will not break down and written as is. Please take a minute to try to write the total ionic equation between lithium phosphate and calcium chloride. I hope you came up with something like this. In this equation, you'll have 6 lithium ions in the aqueous phase, 2 phosphate ions in the aqueous phase, plus 3 calcium ions in the aqueous phase, 6 chloride ions in the aqueous phase, form 6 lithium ions in the aqueous phase, and 6 chloride ions in the aqueous phase, and 1 calcium phosphate in the solid state. Now, from the total ionic equation, you can write the net ionic equation. The net ionic equation only focuses on the ions and the species that are really important in this particular reaction. To write this equation, you will need to cancel out spectator ions. Spectator ions are the ions that are exactly the same on both sides. What do I mean by to be exactly the same on both sides? It means that the state of matter and the charge and the number must be the same on the products and the reactants. In this equation, you can see that there are 6 lithium ions in the aqueous phase and 6 chloride ions in the aqueous phase that are exactly the same on both sides. Therefore, they could be canceled out. After you cancel out spectator ions, rewrite everything that is not crossed out so that you could get the net ionic equation. Therefore, the net ionic equation is 2 phosphate ions plus 3 calcium ions, both in the aqueous phase, forms 1 calcium phosphate solid. So that is how you write the molecular, total, and net ionic equation from a chemical reaction. And in this case, it is from a double displacement precipitation reaction.